So welcome back at Devoxx. I'm here today with Chet and Romain, and we're here to talk about, well, Android. And hi, guys. You've been here many years, and this time, this year around, you're here with a gift, right? You came with a present, and it's 4.2. You actually made the release for the conference.
Just for Devoxx, yes.
Yes, I know you did.
Well, and not just us, but a lot of people back home.
Yes.
Absolutely, absolutely. You're just representing all of them. So 4.2 has a number of end-user features. Do you want to mention a few? And do you want to maybe show the devices
that actually... Yeah, if you can show the device to the camera here. So one of the biggest new features is multiple users, only for tablets at the moment. But you can create multiple accounts, and you know each account has its own settings, its own applications, everything is separate.
But you do share applications?
If you install the same... yes and no. If you install the same applications on two accounts, we share the data. But it's different applications. Applications are linked to your account, to your Google account.
But it doesn't have to get downloaded twice for two different users. Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
We do have widgets on the lock screen now. So the same widgets that you love on the home screen, you can install them on the lock screen as well. So you don't have to unlock the device before you can do something like check your calendar or listen to a song.
So you have access to the camera as well
from
the home screen?
On the phones, yes. You have access to the camera.
Okay.
Yes.
And do you want to talk about the new features in the phone?
We can do that.
The new camera features on the phone, or the camera in general.
So there's a couple of features that are worth calling out. One is HD. HD?
HDR.
HDR. I'm not a camera person. HDR. So you can take...
We invited that guy.
Why don't you explain it? You're the camera person. I'll talk about Photosphere.
We have HDR on devices that support it. It's a high dynamic range. It helps you take picture when you have a high contrast in the scene. For instance, you have a backlit person or backlit scene. You can use HDR to bring back all the details that are in the shadows or in the highlights. It works amazingly well. We also have the Photosphere. It's an expansion of panoramas, but now they are full 360 degrees, so a real sphere. And it generates a photo that's just a simple JPEG that you can share with anybody. But we have special players on the phone and on Google Plus online. And you have this interactive 3D panorama, and you can play with it and look around, and you know you have like this 3D feel of the scene.
Yeah, I've used it. It's awesome. And I've seen people play with it here. And,
yeah, it's a lot of fun to take those pictures.
It's a lot of fun. So quick settings, there are a few other features.
Yeah, we have a lot of other features. There's the new keyboard where we have gesture typing, so now you just have to swipe over the letters. It's actually impressive, like it's amazing.
It's
I don't even know how it can
accurate.
Work.
Accurate. You spell out these sentences by gesturing. You think you're missing things and it just interprets the right word. It's really incredible.
So these are all end user features, so we all benefit from that. What about developer features? So I hear there's things about being able to drive a second display.
Right, so we've got multiple displays, and this is interesting in a couple of different ways. First of all, you can have a multiple display. You can plug in through, say, HDMI to an external display, and the application can detect all the displays that are currently configured on the device and can detect when they're plugged in and when they're removed, and then it can choose to play different content on that other display. And if it's protected content, then you want to know that it's a secure line and secure stream to that other device, and so you can query and say, is this going to be a protected stream?
Okay.
And then there's also the ability to, on the Nexus 4, to play through wireless to HDMI. So you can have a wireless HDMI connection through a dongle that's a separate device that you then attach to your display device, your TV.
Yeah.
And then you can actually play HDMI, but it's just going wireless the whole time. And it looks like any other external display device.
So from a developer perspective, I have two screens. It's not just mirroring the exact same screen.
No, by default, we'll do the mirroring, but the application can request to not do that. And then you have, it's like you create a simple dialogue on the other screen, and you can use your normal views, you can draw with OpenGL if you want, you can do really anything you want with that second
display.
So
use cases would be, of course, presenting and having a presenter console.
Yeah, I mean, a great example is what we shipped today, like the Play Movies application. We play the movie on the second display, and on your home device, on the host, on the tablet or the phone, you see the play controls. So you can pause, play, seek, and you only see the movie on the other display.
Okay, great. Do you want to talk about Daydream and what that is?
Daydreams are new screensaver-ish things. You can create these applications that can play when the screen times out. And so you can see beautiful things like the photos in gallery that are that are wafting by on the screen, but they can also be interactive. So if you actually want to, some of the screensavers that we ship are interactive. Like there's a photo table, you see the tables, the photos going by, and you can tap on one of the photos and it'll expand in, expand out. You can fling it out of the way. There's another one that's Currents.
Currents, so it shows you
a reader application.
Yeah, it shows you the news from your feeds. And if you see a news that you're interested in, you can tap on it and you get more details about it. Okay. And of course, it's a public API, so anybody can write a daydream. It's very easy to do. It's very similar to writing an activity or a normal application. And again, you can do whatever you want. You have views, you have OpenGL, uh-huh. you have the canvas. Very easy to do.
You always wondered what was happening on your Android device when it went to sleep, and now you know.
Now I know. So, of course, so if it wasn't obvious for people listening, this is an update to Jelly Bean. Mm-hmm. So this is 4.2. Who is getting the update and when, do you know?
So the OTA has already started yesterday for Galaxy Nexus and Nexus 7. And the Nexus 10 and the Nexus 4 are coming out with 4.2 pre-installed. And the source code is available in the Android open source project.
It's been rolled out, or maybe it's there already.
It's already there, yeah. Sorry.
SDK came out yesterday.
The SDK is available. The SDK actually has a change in the SDK. We now bundle the ID in the SDK. So, you know, one download, you have the plugin, the ID, the SDK, all the tools, everything is in one bundle. It's easier.
Awesome. And this is all synced on level 17?
It's all synced on level 17.
Great.
No extra downloads.
Anything else you want to point out from a developer perspective or
4.2? There are a lot of little things. We publish API diffs, so you can see the differences between this new API level and the previous one. Go check it out. There are a lot of little changes that can be very useful to you. They're not big features, so we're not calling them out here. But they might save your life when you're writing your application. So,
we also spent about an hour talking about this just a couple hours ago, and that talk will hopefully be available on Parlays.com
soon.
So there's a lot more detail, especially about the developer features.
Right, and I also want to take this chance to plug Google Developer Live. We have developer advocates running mm-hmm. office hours and presenting. And they will be spending some time on the new version of Android of 4.2 in the coming weeks. So check out developers.google.com/live/Android.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
All right. Thanks.